This is a demo of the Siel MK-610 keyboard, which is currently for sale. This one has been heavily modified, as you might be able to guess by the jacks here, and then the Altoids tin, which I so unbeautifully had to affix to it to put all the jacks in there. Anyway, I'll go through the main functions of the keyboard first, just so you can hear everything as is without any of the mods. So if I stop the drum machine, a little bit of background noise, never killed anybody. And now we've got the split, the bass, the arpeggio, the modulation, and the memory on. So that's an overview of all the voices. I'll go through all of the preset rhythms real quick. So that's all of the major functions. Now I'll start going through the mods left to right. So we've got the main output left, main output right. There's some things like the toms and a couple other voices that are kind of stereo panned a little bit, not very much. This one's an interesting one because you might see that there's something labeled bass here, but I could never get it to come out of the main output. So via poking around on the circuit board, I actually found the bass. Let's see, so turn it back up. Do a little bit of filtering to that. Then there's the main keys output only. Which is useful if you want to isolate the kick and the bass and everything. There's a raw noise output, which is very loud, so I'm going to turn it down just a little bit. And then there's one that I labeled fun. I'll explain it before I plug in. It's basically, there's a key scanning sort of method used to count which keys are being played, something to do with polyphony, and so that you'll hear a tone when I plug this in, and then if the more keys I press down, the lower the tone gets. That's the way I'm assuming it was used to keep track of all of the polyphony, the different notes. So now jumping to the Altoids 10, we have individual outputs for the arpeggio, chords, kick, snare, toms, hats, and then we have some CV triggers, basically, not modern CV 5 volts necessarily. I haven't measured it with a scope, but there's the chords when they come in. There's low, middle, and high to each of the chords, so that each of those has a trigger. The arpeggio has a trigger, the kick, and the closed hats. Those are the only ones that I could find. Oh, and there's the clock output, which I will be using with this Korg KR55 drum machine that I have. Anyway, back to the demo. I'll start off with just the arpeggio. And the cool thing about most of these mods is that they're switchable, so when I patch into the arpeggio here, it takes it out of the main voice. So, and I'll pan those out for you to hear it a little easier. They don't really seem like they're synchronized, but if you have a clock divider or multiplier, then you can fairly easily correct it. I believe it's 12 pulses to 1. I'm not... You'll have to do some experiments, but just to prove that they're synchronized... That's the snare that's being triggered on the KR55. That's the chords. Here's the arp.